Φίλες και φίλοι, καλησπέρα. Έχουμε μαζί μας τον μεγάλο Σαρούνας Γιασικεβίτσιους. Coach Saras, welcome in Greece.
Thank you very much.
After experience as a head coach 3 years in the new format of the EuroLeague, which are your thoughts about this season with these extra 2 teams, which makes the competition looks a little bit more exciting and a little bit more difficult?
I think everything is fine. I think we always wanted more games. It makes it more difficult to, you know, to compete at the highest level all the time. You have to make a lot of adjustments. I would say the only negative would be the fact is that before some games, one of the teams sometimes have longer rest, and we are not used to this in Europe. Some teams will play Tuesday, Friday, when the opponent can easily play Wednesday, Friday. You know, and that one day is a huge, huge advantage, whether you're traveling or not. So, like always, there's a good things and bad things, but in general, I think we want, you know, more games in European basketball because EuroLeague is the best competition.
And it seems that everybody can win against everybody.
It's always been with this EuroLeague like this. You know, a lot of times people talk about surprises, but in EuroLeague, you know, I don't know what to surprise anymore.
The fact that Žalgiris has a bigger budget than the previous 2 years. Makes it more easy to understand that you know it doesn't take the money you know to win in basketball all the time.
I think you know the budget is coming from whatever we won in the last games in the last years. But no, it doesn't change. We still are the same team who we are. I mean, the numbers are a little bit increased, but you know we don't feel that. And the biggest problem is that every year we have to you know start from zero because bigger teams take you know 5 or 6 of our players. So. It's not easy to handle, but we also accepted this fact, and this is what you know we already dealing with, you know, over the course of time.
For you, coming here is a special game, but also at the same time, just another game.
Yeah, it's always great to come to Akka. You know, always you know you're feeling so many memories and so many good things, so many friends I have here. When the game starts, you know, or when the preparation, you're still doing exactly the same things that you do all the time. As far as our basketball, you know, I think people constantly, I say the same thing, people confuse good or bad basketball with good or bad results. You know, I think we should not confuse that. I think everybody respects the way Žalgiris plays and the way Žalgiris fights. We have people who, you know, sacrificing a lot for our club. And it's unfortunate we had some, you know, a run of bad results, but they were just a little bit circumstances, you know, of some, you know, some things. I don't think Žalgiris is playing a lot different from the years past. I think we're moving the ball well, we're creating, we're playing good, solid defense. Sometimes it doesn't guarantee good results.
How difficult was to deal with losing, and especially what are the takeaways that you earned throughout this process?
I think, you know, it's not pleasant at all, you know, to lose 9 games in a row, and it's something that probably I went through for the first time in my life. At the same time, you know, you got to take emotions away from it and analyze why things are happening and what we're doing. And I'm happy with more or less the way we played in that time. Like I said, we still played good, solid defense. We created. We lost the game on 2 or 3 details. And this is exactly what we're lacking as a young team. You know, I mean, we just cannot close the games in certain situations, and 2 or 3 mistakes more than it should be, it's really hurting us in the win or loss column.
I was fortunate enough to open the season with the first interview with Željko Bradović of 2020, and he told me great things about your friendship, about your basketball discussion, and I was wondering, you know, 2 guys that are, you know, very successful and very bright basketball minds, you know. What do these guys discussing, you know, when they're facing losing periods?
Yeah, no, we talk a little bit about the situation of our teams, but not too much. You know, usually you try to catch up a little bit when we see each other. You know, a lot of times we start talking about other things, then we will eventually ending up in basketball, you know, unfortunately for both. And yeah, you know, you just try to, you know, basically it's not about our profession a lot. It's mainly about, you know, 2 guys try to catch up a little bit and have a good time when you go out, just to go away from all this madness that surrounds us.
2 years after Žalgiris was the most pleasant surprise in Europe. You stated that your goal is to bring it to Kaunas at some point, you know, if it's possible. Do you see that this is very difficult, and you know, as time goes by, maybe you're trying, you know, to understand that probably the new challenge will be far from Kaunas?
Well, I mean, I'm just trying to do my job in the best way possible. You know, I'm very happy where I am. I always said I want to work with great people in a good organization, and this is exactly what I have and more. And you know, so I'm very happy. I'm very happy where I am. I don't know when the time will come for the new challenges. Then we'll cross that bridge.
In the NBA, what happened in the summer?
Nothing. We spoke. We dealt with you know, with some situations, and it didn't happen.
Last but not least, you know, how is it possible for a basketball legend and a current coach of the EuroLeague to be relaxed when he follows his son's game?
Oh, I mean, he's not at that point where I really tell him something. I think the best, the most important thing is for him to continue loving the game, to enjoy. And I think it's not the time to push the kid a lot. I think at when he grows older, probably I will get more involved and try to help him out, because then he will understand what's expected more of him. You know, right now, I think the kids should be all about fun and having a great time.